Hello, Jim Howard here in Fort Worth, Texas. Today's date, it is July 28th of 2017. I'm running Windows 10. I'm running the Insiders Preview, and it's up to build 16251. Just in case you were, you can see it on the screen there, just in case you were wondering. I'm always messing with stuff around here, hooking stuff up and unhooking something and spending too much money. I'll buy something and then just think that I have to have it and that I'm going to use it, and then I don't use it, or I use it for a little short period of time and then I put it away. Lots of stuff I give away, but I end up with a lot of stuff also on the shelf, and then I feel guilty and think I should use it. So I'm always switching things around. Right now I'm using my LG long monitor, I guess they call them the wide monitor, and I can have two browser windows open here side by side. In this case I have the camera running, and that's the Logitech USB camera. That's that one over there. There's one up on top of here. This is the, I think, Bro, whatever they're, I think it's their most advanced one, does 4K. And this does 1080. Let me switch to it. It's the, what, I can't remember anymore. But anyway, it does 1080p. So, as you know, in the past I had two computers side by side. Well, this is what I had the last time. This is the Chromebox. Let me disconnect the AC power supply here before I hook it up and choke myself or something. It's the wrong camera. ASUS Chromebox has 4 gigabyte of memory in it, and runs the Chrome operating system, of course. This is a flash card that I put in there. But you can plug a network cable, but it works just fine using Wi-Fi also. And right now, recently, I've been getting 60 megs down when hooked to the cable, but also Wi-Fi I'm getting 60 down, which is, there for a while I was getting 30 down when I tried Wi-Fi. This has two, let me do this, hang on a second. There it is. This has two USB 3.0, and it has a HDMI port, and it has a display port, which I'm not familiar with using the display ports. Then it has a sound, a jack for the sound. On the side it has a HD card. Looks like a large one could go in there. I should have ordered one of those. But I've hooked this up before, just a week or so ago, with a different monitor, and works well. That's with 4K of 4 gigabyte of memory. My first computer had 64K of memory. When I got it had 4K of memory. I upgraded it to 64. No, I upgraded to 48K, I think it was. Radio Shack Model 1. I've run two monitors side by side, and that's okay. But what I want to do is, what I prefer to do is run one monitor, but with two computers hooked into it, so I can use two computers by just hitting the switch And I'm using one, we use one monitor that way, one keyboard, one mouse. Now I have a pretty good sized desk here, but, and I can put another monitor there. So I could have a, you know, this computer could be, you know, sitting over there any place, and a monitor would be fine. But when I try to add a keyboard and a mouse for another computer, there just isn't, you know, there's not room, and it gets confusing. Gets confusing as to which one is which. Oh, I think I may, you can buy these with 2 gigabyte of memory, and it works okay with 2 gigabyte of memory. And I think that's $158 approximately right now. Or you can purchase, I think it's about $200 with 4 gigabytes of memory. But I think, and it works, and with 4 gigabytes, that should be all you'd need using the Chrome operating system. But for about $62, I can get 8 gigabyte of memory, and I think next month I'm going to upgrade this to 8 gigabytes of memory. But my project for today, I'm waiting for delivery of an adapter and a cable. This adapter, because this monitor does not have VGA on the back. It just has HDMI. And this definitely does not have, doesn't support a printer, in fact. I haven't tried, even tried using a printer. There's a way to do it, but I haven't even got into that yet. But the cable here that I have used in the past and will be using as soon as I get my delivery today. The last week or whatever, the monitor I was using did have VGA, so I was, but here's the cable that's going to hook these two computers up. Let me go to it here. I'll put the links for these. That's not it. That's one of the cables I'm waiting for today. Here's the cable, and there's other ones you can buy. In fact, I have one on the shelf. So what you do with this, this end here, I will come out of my monitor here, and I will come out, since I'm getting the cable I'm getting today, I gotta wipe my nose, I think. I will use that cable with an HDMI on one end, and I will plug it into this monitor, and then on the other end will be this VGA. I think I show that here. Yes. So this will plug into my monitor. This will plug in here. Now there are two USB ports, so my keyboard will plug in here, or here, it doesn't matter, but the mouse is a USB mouse, it will plug in here. So I'll have a monitor and a mouse and a keyboard plugged into here. Now there's two of these, this is one of them, and they're identical, of course. So on my Windows 10 computer that's over here, I'll plug that into a USB, I'll plug this into USB, and I will plug that into a VGA on the computer there. And now with this other cable, which is identical, I will plug into USB on my Chromebox, and I'll plug into the other USB, and then since this does not have a VGA on it, I will use this adapter. So this is going to plug into the Chromebox here on the back. And then on this end here, I will plug in this cable. Then I will have both of the computers here, my Windows 10 desktop computer and this Chromebox will be hooked up. Now there is a little switch here. And when I get these hooked up and booted up, hitting this switch will switch between the computers. And there's a light, not that it matters, but there's a light here that will switch. So that's it. So that's the project for today. And I think everything will go smoothly. I've hooked up both. I'm not sure though when this boots up, because this monitor here is, what size is it? 25 by something. It's a 25 inch monitor. So it may be that the display from this, I'm not sure, I can't remember now. Because I'm not sure I've hooked this up to this monitor. So it might be that I'll have reduced size on this, or it may fill the whole screen. We'll find out, I guess, here in a little while. So what else? I think that's it. Oh, well, let me ramble here for a while. My Apple app in the Apple store all of a sudden is not working, and I have no idea how to fix it or anything else. So I'm hoping maybe that their upgrade may take care of that. If not, I'm not sure what will happen to that Apple app. The Android app is still working. I would like the Apple or the Android app. I have a little bit of an idea how to go in and change it and do things with it. I haven't really got into it much, but I do have that capability to go in. I'm thinking about upgrading both of those and making them better apps. New subject. I think it's almost next month. I think this next month I'm going to try and do the contest thing that I'm talking about. And then I think I plan to do a contest each month. The only thing keeping me from doing the contest is I need to have it set up so that you have to do a little something in order to get it. And I'm thinking that maybe it would be you have to subscribe, but if you're already subscribed, you know, you wouldn't, that'd be taken care of. And maybe the other thing is watch a short video, 5-minute video, 10-minute video at max. And that would be it. But I need to get the video ready. I can't, you know, need to do that. So I think we're going to have a contest this next month. Since an awful lot of you are interested in headphones, I get a lot of views for headphones. I think maybe I'll give away a set of headphones. But I haven't decided yet, so if there's something else that you would like to see in the giveaway, let me know and I'll think about it. And two, when I set this up, I haven't done this yet. I went and checked a little bit to see how it worked. And it'll be through Amazon. So when I pick out what's going to be given away, and when I go in there and pay them and set the rules for what a person has to do to be in the contest. And then I click on purchase or whatever. It's over. I mean, I will post, you know, hey, this is the contest and here's what you do and here's the link or whatever. But Amazon's software or whatever they do, you know, they do the picking, they notify the winner. Of course, I'm sure I get a notice too, and I will also try to notify the winner. So I think we'll be doing this next month. I just next as quick as I can here and get that taken care of and get it started. Guess I need to think a little bit. You know, do I want to encourage some people to subscribe, or do I just want them to watch this video? Which so I'm not sure. But that's something to work on. I think that's it. I appreciate you watching. I think I'm just going to end this video, and because the next video, you know, that I make that's just a rambling one like this, I'll let you know how this all worked out. I don't think there's any reason to add on to this video that I guess I'll put in the underneath it. I'll post this video now, and then when the parts come and I hook everything up, then I'll just post underneath that, hey, it's operational. So I do thank you very much for watching.